What's up, y'all? It's Jonathan Rollins. I'm back with another reaction to a Swedish classic. All right, before we get started, I want to remind you about my comedy club, The Laugh House. Go to thelaughhouse.se to see what we got going on. There are two more shows this season, one of which is Quan Win Hoang, comedian from London, that's coming through to hang out with us, and that's on June 11th. And then, just 11 days later, on June 22nd, Magnus Bettinier is putting on two shows, not one, but two shows, 7 o'clock and 9 o'clock. I recommend the later show because I'm a party animal. What can I say? But go to laughhouse.se to get tickets for one of those shows. And also, you can check out my podcast. I have Sovahenda, Teach Me Sweden, and Svennefell. You can get all of those wherever you get your podcasts. Now, for today's reaction, I will be reacting to Elena Demonstrerar. A little bit about the song. It was released in 1974 on the album Barn Låtar. And first off, I have to apologize because I misread the title over and over again. A little embarrassing when I think about it, because it says clear as day. Somebody made the suggestion. I copied it, pasted to make sure I didn't mess it up. And what do? I read it wrong. I'm so used to heavens and otherworldly stuff that I thought I was seeing Englana, but it's Eliana. It's about moose. So, sorry about that. And people were correcting me too. They were writing it like, it's not Englana. And I was like, what, am I saying it wrong? I was like, am I pronouncing angels wrong? I mean, it's like the angels are protesting. I don't know. But now I know that it's not angels protesting. It's moose protesting. And it makes sense now because the song is for kids. It's about angry moose out here picketing or something like that, I'm guessing, you know? So now I've revamped my brain to be ready to handle a song made for kids. The song didn't chart at all. Probably also due to the fact that it was made for kids. So I'm ready to check it out and see what made it a classic. Like, people think this song is a classic, even though it wasn't commercially very successful. So I'm intrigued. James and Carden were a couple. They made this song the same year Carden got a divorce. So I'm wondering if James had something to do with Carden getting a divorce. Maybe he swept her off her feet and she was like, you know what? I need to break up with my guy. I couldn't find any juice on it. Even though I was trying to be nosy and messy, found nothing. So if you know anything about that, like if they were like creeping, let me know. Put it in the comments. They were together for a while and released three albums. Two of them were to kids and the other one was for adults. James continued making music afterwards and Karin, she kept on developing music and education together. So they went their separate ways, eventually breaking up and Carden passed away in 2018. As I like to say, her music lives on. So I'm looking forward to checking it out. I'm intrigued by the pairing of these two people. And I'm guessing that the song is gonna go a little bit like Eliana Demonstrera. Eliana e Ari. That's my guess, and I'm sticking to it. And we'll see how close I am. I got my lyrics right here, so I can check them out as I listen. And here we go. Eliana Demonstrera by James O'Carden.
Vi älgar har samlats här ikväll för att prata om hur vi ska göra för att få det bättre här i skogen. Älgarna har ju tidigare alltid fått bestämma över sig själva. Men nu har vi fått vissa problem som vi måste ta itu med. Älgarna demonstrerar, älgarna har fått nog. Älgarna vill ha trygghet här i sin egen skog. Vi älgar kräver, för det första, totalt förbud mot all jakt i skogen. För det andra, stoppa alla kalhyggen. Och för det tredje, fri passage över alla vägar. Älgarna demonstrerar, älgarna har fått nog.
okay, I'm liking this. I like the hum and the whole thing, and then how they got it, like, I feel like I'm listening to a stage play, man. I'm really into it. It's really good. I even like how they seem really dedicated, like into it, doing the song in this way. I'm liking it.
Älgarna demonstrerar makt, älgarna har fått nog makt. Älgarna vill ha trygghet makt, här i sin egen skog makt.
Vi älgar vill ha större jämlikhet.
Tror jag det.
Och vi måste få bort biltrafiken från vägarna. Ni vet, många av våra kamrater råkar illa ut på vägarna. Vidare. Besprutning av mat måste omedelbart upphöra. Vi mår inte bra av det. Låt oss enas under parollen. Fritt fram i skogen! Fritt fram i skogen!
Älgarna demonstrerar makt. Älgarna har fått nog makt. Älgarna vill ha trygghet makt. Här i sin egen skog makt. Älgarna demonstrerar makt. Älgarna har fått nog makt. Älgarna vill ha trygghet makt. Här i sin egen skog makt. Älgarna demonstrerar 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 makt.
Det ska bli skönt att få bort allt dumt förtal om att vi skulle hålla gång och dansa bossa nova i skogen.
Jo, Elbert, det var ett underbart tal du höll. Jag är så stolt över dig.
Prat, jag gör bara min plikt som vanlig hedlig älge.
So that was Älgarna Demonstrerar by James Åkerkarden. Again, it's another demonstration of how good y'all are at making music. Like, they put together this really cool song that was like layered and everything, and it's silly in the end, you know what I mean? Like, it's not deep at all, you know? They're telling the story through the song, and it's four kids, and it's really cool, man. I liked it a lot. And it was technically good elements of music packed into this thing as well. I liked it with the harmony of I like later when she brought it up another octave and with the singing, and then the simple like drums and it was really good. Can't call it a banger. No, it doesn't make sense to call that a banger, but it was a cool experience checking it out, I'll say that. And it wasn't bad as a song, but it's not a banger, of course. I'm not gonna be like, I really need to hear the Moose song right now in the future. So that was that, and we're gonna keep this train rolling, as I like to say. The next song I'll be reacting to is Gråt Inga Tårar by Thorleifs. Looking forward to that. Stay tuned. Don't forget to like, subscribe, get notification on all that jazz. And most importantly, spread the word. Let people know about this American comedian living in Sweden, reacting to classic Swedish music. You can go back and check out the songs that I've reacted to. And if there's something that I haven't reacted to that you think I need to react to, how did I miss that? Then put it in the comments. I look through the comments and grab songs and add to the list all the time. And soon I'll be putting up the next 5 songs that I'll be reacting to. So look out for that and keep the interaction going. I'm open to this. I'm learning no matter what. I'm learning. So keep sending them at me and I'll keep reacting to them. Thanks again. Take care of yourselves and I'll see you next classic. Peace.